Earthworm Jim, a super suited fall. Earthworm Jim, a savior to us all. Fucking bats.
Fucking bats.
Really, I think I'm just super invincible because I got my my double daggers. It makes me invincible. Everybody knows that.
Yeah, that wouldn't work out in Warband, for sure.
Dual daggers! Huh.
I don't think you can dual wield anything in Modern Blade, actually.
That is so sad.
I've never seen it happen, but I don't know. Maybe.
Dual wielding is like basic shit, man.
I don't know.
Take a sword and put it in your hand, and then you take another sword and you put it in your other hand.
It's not very convenient. I mean, you know how to dual wield, and then the enemy decides to pull out archers. It's not very convenient, if you ask me.
It's probably not the best thing that could happen, but it's acceptable.
Although, if you're good enough in Modern Blade, you can just dodge arrows without even having a shield. It's not that difficult, actually.
If you're elite.
Nah, you just...
Are you elite enough, dude, to save the president?
You just need to make sure you didn't smoke crystal meth at your youth, and that's it. So you could still have some kind of reaction time.
But I did!
Well then, I guess you're just not cut out for King of the Clonk.
I'm watching this dude die to traps, and now he's dead. Ooh.
You might have noticed that there are some interesting things on the ground, like giant larva or big piles of shit. In case you couldn't figure it out on your own, which is very difficult, I must add, because it's quite obvious, but they are spawners. They spawn things. Like this larva. It spawns larva. No fucking shit.
I did have that figured out, but
But you know, we gotta help out that one person. He's a bit slow.
Yeah, why you wanna kill those things?
Wait.
Oh, you went down. Ow! Ow! Fuck!
That larva's got the fucking spread shot. He must have been very good at this game. Managed to keep a fucking spread shot all this time. Sorry, I'm all out of faith.
Pray! 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 Let's pray a game. Oh my god.
Oh, it looks like that...
How did we get that guy?
Looks like we need to turn off that spike trap, but we need to find a switch for it. Look out for a red switch.
Can't go down that way.
No, but we can go down that way.
Ooh! Super victory!
That looks like the kind of person I want to talk with.
A man with a thing over his head?
Yeah, I believe he might have something for me. Oh, this...
Push a button.
This looks like bullshit.
If we get a stick...
I guess we have to go downstairs and just go around. Or, yeah, actually, that's exactly what we needed to do. Go downstairs and pick up a key. Because that's all we can do on that end.
Well, there's some puzzle elements to this game as well, which I don't know if I agree with, but that's okay.
There's nothing wrong with a little puzzle in your game. As long as it doesn't go like some puzzles in Soul Axiom.
People love puzzles, except for Dayton.
Why do you hate puzzles?
Because I'm stupid.
Because
I'm stupid!
Well, that's a pretty straightforward answer. Not sure what I expected.
Like, yeah, if I was good at puzzles, I'd probably like them a lot more. But instead I go, what the fuck am I supposed to do here? This is a bunch of shit. Oh.
Well, I'm not too smart when it comes to puzzles myself, but I do like to dabble in them every now and then.
Yeah, give your brain a little stretch.
Might as well, because it's the only thing that could use a stretch nowadays.
Oh, are you well stretched everywhere else?
Nah. I'll have you know that I'm actually a quad amputee. And I'm playing with the power of my mind.
That is amazing.
It is quite amazing. Only achievable because of Slav Engine 3.
Slav Engine 3. Cutting edge technology. For the cutting edge man.
Wow, plus one armor. Uh-huh. That means we die slightly less easily. Unfortunately, this combat upgrade guy is only level 1, which means he doesn't have jack and shit to offer.
Boo!
We need to find the same guy, but level 2.
So why don't we just fight that guy until he levels up?
Because this is not
RuneScape. Seems pretty basic. I kill everything, yeah! Look out for me, super rogue! Super dog.
Better not die on me, super rogue, or else it's a fucking freedom force all over again.
I haven't been hit yet, but now that I said something, I probably will.
I haven't been killed yet. Let's check that map. 10 deaths.
not bad.
At least it's not 10,000.
Could have been a lot worse. Yeah.
Yet.
I've got as many lives as I need. Everything's awesome.
Speaking of Freedom Force, have you ever played that game?
Mm-mm. I play Bro Force.
Have you ever heard of it?
Nope.
Not surprising at all. It's kind of old.
Is it like another Sega Genesis title?
Nah, it's a PC title. It's pretty fun, actually. You play with a squad of superheroes, and you do superhero stuff, like fight evil.
I'm pretty good at fighting evil.
It involves quite a bit of strategy, though, because for the first game, at least, your superheroes are pretty damn fresh at the superhero business, let's say.
They suck.
Yeah, especially their fucking leader. He gets killed by bullet.
Yeah, that's not too super.
Which is kind of ironic, considering that he nearly died from a bullet before he became a superhero.
Was it a radioactive bullet?
No, actually the story is a bit different on that game. Apparently aliens want to invade Earth, but their leader is such a cunt, he doesn't even want to put any effort in destroying Earth. He wants to give the most evil of all men some of his secret weapon, the Energy X, and let them destroy Earth on their own. Probably because he's very lazy, but who knows. Unfortunately, somebody from his own ranks figures that out by being a cunt and decides that he's gonna do the exact opposite, steal some of that same Energy X and find the complete opposite people, the best of the best. Unfortunately, the big bad alien leader doesn't take too long to catch on to that idea. So he gets chased down, his ship gets blown up, he doesn't die, but all the Energy X canisters get flung all over the fucking Earth.
Ugh.
Which does lead to some very interesting things happening. One in particular is the birth of the Freedom Force leader, Minuteman, who, well, he got pretty much resurrected by clutching the statue of the Minuteman as it was zapped with that Energy X. It's pretty cool, actually.
Like a Minuteman?
Yeah, like the actual Minuteman, you know? The historical figure.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the Minute Maid mascot.
No.
The new mascot from Minute Maid.
No.
It's the Minute Man. It's not even that good of a joke, but I had some chuckles.
I do find it very interesting that the Energy X in question is so potent that it not only resurrected the guy from near death, but it also made him younger, because by the time he was shot, he was pretty much in his 80s. And then he got turned back to somewhere around late 30s at most.
80-year-old people do not survive gunshots.
No, he barely survived that from what I saw in the story. But boy, did he survive that. Now he can fucking jump houses.
Yeah, excessive survival.
That's the power of Energy X. It can do anything.
Yeah, it made the Powerpuff Girls too.
I do think that the Freedom Force has led to some of the most unique heroes and villains, however. I've never seen anything other than what the game has to offer, actually. What makes the game so much more fun for me. I really recommend it to everyone.
Freedom Force.
Yeah.
Is it on Steam?
Yeah, it is on Steam. I actually own both of the games from the series. Unfortunately, the series are very short. There's only two games. I don't know why they didn't make more sequels, but I'm guessing they had some budget constraints or something.
Yeah, it just didn't sell enough, probably.
I know it had a lot of popularity because, well, it was probably the most original thing that came out at that point in time. I mean, who wouldn't want to have the most patriotic, bullshit-ass group of superheroes from a place known as Patriot City, no less, in America, fighting the literal living Soviet Union mascot, who happens to be called Nuclear Winter, whose superpowers are, well, ice-based, no less. And he's fucking crazy, too. I like that fucking guy. Probably the best villain in the entire game, besides Time Master.
Because he's Soviets?
No, it's
because... You like Tsakubliet?
No, it's because as soon as he becomes the super villain, he doesn't fuck around. He steals a nuke. He throws down...
Creates Nuclear Winter.
He throws down the entire Patriot City, attacked an aircraft carrier, stole the nuke, and nearly blew it up.
He's a man's man.
He's fucking badass. I think the only guy that's more badass than him is Time Master, for obvious reasons. And
well,
that
yeah.
The reasons are, of course, his endless time puns. He loves them.
You just go back in time before the bomb was even made, and then, other thing. Get the fuck out of here! I woke everything
every
up in here.
Every fucking time I want to do something that he doesn't want to do. The time is not yet right. And I just groan a little. I mean,
that's how you know it's good, though.
I do like a good pun, but Time Master is something special. But I can talk about
all
that
about
game
them
all
puns.
Day, really. Freedom Force is good. I recommend checking it out. It's really worth the money. And I don't think
like something I'd like.
I don't think it even costs a lot nowadays.
They're like, you want to talk about destroying Soviet communism? And I'm like, yeah, dude, I'm American.
I will say this, the first game in the series, which is just called Freedom Force, is not easy at all. It's pretty safe to say that the first time around, you should play on easy mode, because you will die a lot.
I'm gonna die a lot now!
I died a lot, and I know how to play it.
I'm finally getting this rogue down, I think.
Pick up the apple before you get killed.
Good idea.
There's another
still
one.
Still having
over
a
there.
Little trouble watching my health, apparently.
You need to work on your peripheral vision.
Yeah, I get tunnel vision playing a game like this. I'm like, oh, everything's awesome.
Here's another orange apple over here. You should pick it up.
I'll need it. Yeah.
We spent a little bit too long on this one spot. We need to make up for it. You also got a potion of super restore.
Oh yeah. Like I'm gonna need that. I'm already super restored, son. Oh god. Get this. Get out. That'll do.
Since we're doing this collaboration, I might as well take my chances to ask some very controversial questions.
Uh-oh.
Oh, SpaghettiOs! Nah, it's not gonna be that bad.
I shall answer honestly, probably.
Well, I'm not gonna ask about your dick size, because that's not really my problem.
Or your blessing, as it were.
It can't be bigger than mine. anyway, on the topic at hand, what kind of consoles have you grown up with?
Started with the Super Nintendo when I was 5 years old. Well, I got a Game Boy very first thing. Oh. And then Super Nintendo, and then I stuck with Nintendo like the whole time up until the GameCube. And then the Wii, I think I did buy a Wii, but I never played it. And then I kind of switched to PCs and never looked back.
I noticed that's a pretty common thing amongst Americans. They usually stick around the Nintendos.
Yeah, I couldn't say why, but I'll definitely
confirm. I can definitely see why, though. The NES library all by itself is pretty damn good. However, I never got to taste it.
It's worth a taste.
I tried one game so far. It was just a ROM hack, actually, of some other game. I don't remember what the game is called, but the ROM hack is Batman and Flash. Where you can,
that's kind of fun.
Yeah, you can play as either Batman or Flash or both at the same time. It's kind of fun, actually. I liked it. And I can definitely...
Yeah, I can get behind that.
That's how I got the idea that the NES is definitely better than what some people might let you think. By the way, this guy sells health and mana upgrades.
Fuck, I have no money. I bought those combo upgrades instead.
But yeah, like,
well, the Sega Genesis was put out before the Super Nintendo, so it's
I think it was put up as a direct competition to the NES at the time.
Yeah. So if you're comparing Nintendo versus Sega Genesis, the fucking Sega definitely wins. But Super Nintendo versus Sega Genesis,
that's a bit more complicated debate, I would say, because we both have things that make them better in their own right. But to say outright which one is better than the other, it's kind of difficult.
Yeah, it's a lot of personal preference for sure.
I think it's mostly, if not entirely, personal preference at this point.
At this point, definitely. Back then, you had to make a choice.
Yeah, back then it's most definitely something that you had to think about before doing anything, because money was kind of tight.
Yeah.
Not to mention the damn consoles cost like a good car.
Yeah, it was expensive as shit. And that's why I got so excited for the console wars and stuff when, Sega and Nintendo were both like, we have the cheaper games, and everything was like $20. I was buying fucking mainstream titles for $20.
But here's the thing, actually. I do recall owning some sort of other console before the Sega Genesis. I just don't know what it is.
Atari.
I don't know. I don't think so. It could have been an NES, actually, because I had seen the other cartridges that went with it, and it's nothing that the Atari used. It was more akin to a Sega Genesis cartridge or an NES cartridge. It was pretty...
That's strange.
It was pretty bland cartridge. Like, you wouldn't be able to tell which console it would go for. But I think it was an NES, actually, because... I don't know. I can't remember exactly everything about it. I just remember that it was distinctly very black and much blockier than a Sega Genesis. Very reminiscent of the regular NES, actually, not the top loader.
Was it a knockoff console?
Maybe. I don't know, that's a thing. For all I know, it could have been the Sega Master System, actually.
Yeah, it doesn't ring bells, but then again, I was mostly like Nintendo, so
I don't know either.
42 combo, oh, that's fucking awesome.
I don't know either, and I can't figure it out anymore because the damn thing was broken by the time I was 3. So yeah, that's gonna be one mystery that I'll never find the answers for. But it would be interesting
to
know.
Into the trash it goes.
It would be interesting to know if there was ever a black NES. Maybe there was some kind of a custom-made thing, or I don't know.
Yeah, it's totally possible. I'd never heard of it. I know all the Nintendo stuff I had was mostly gray.
Yeah, from what I've seen, it's either gray or white. Most commonly gray, though. Well, I never figured out what that thing is. Not that I did a lot of research myself, but the earliest thing I can remember? Sega Genesis, all the fucking way. And that lasted for a long time. I'd say about a good... About a good year or two after PS1 came out. That's how long it survived.
Show Sega on. There's a fucking thing.
Too bad the poor console died shortly after, but at least the PS1 managed to keep me busy.
PS1's pretty tasty. I remember playing that as a kid. I think I had the N64, and I was like, oh man, my cousin had a PS1, and I was like, I should totally get one. These are awesome.
I actually tried to fuck around with the N64 emulator at some point, but goddamn, is it a pain in the ass.
Yeah.
It's mostly because of that damn controller.
Jet Force Gemini. Yeah. Like, you don't know where to bind the Z button and shit like that. I basically have to reset the fucking, the control bindings for each different game, which I never had to do for any other emulator before. Yeah. That N64 controller was just fucking weird. The Z trigger is probably what makes it so.
If the only thing you got is an Xbox 360 controller, you have no chance in hell of mapping out every button. I tried.
I got Jet Force Gemini to a decent point. It certainly wasn't like, wow, this feels just like the old console, but it was close enough.
The only thing I tried to emulate was Extreme G2, but that's only because I can't get the PC version to work at all.
Extreme G?
Yeah, it's like a racing game. You race with bikes.
That sounds so familiar. And then they have one bike that's called Grimace, and it's all purple. And I remember picking that one. I think I know what you're talking about.
It could be. I don't remember everything about it. I know it was bikes, futuristic setting, very fucking fast. You could shoot shit. That's all I remember about it.
Yeah, you shoot rockets and shit. I swear I remember that game.
I know it was very popular for the N64. The PC version was pretty good too. It's just that it had this very obnoxious problem of not working past Windows 98.
Goddamn Windows 98!
And it's kind of weird actually, because I had that game and Turok 2 at the same time. Turok 2 still works fine on the Windows 7. And Extreme G2 does not work with anything anywhere past 95.
That's a shame.
It's not that it drops any errors or anything, it just doesn't turn on.
That's the worst kind of error.
Yeah,
because there's no
the error with no fucking
no explanation
error.
Yeah,
that red door still needs one more boss button pushed, which is actually right here. Once we're done with this one, we can actually go fight the boss.
Oh, it's gonna be so good. We're gonna fight a boss.
The first boss.
Boss one. The vendor coin. Hey, don't bite me.
I didn't get to stick around with the PS1 for too long because getting games for it was a big pain in the ass, and they were always Russian. Fuck that noise. Despite what you might think, I cannot speak of a lick's worth of Russian.
Just do the best that you can. That's what I say. What the fuck are we doing down here?
We're fighting boss.
The queen!
Try the buttons next to the queen. They could prove useful. Well, sort of.
Maybe? Oh shit! Oh god! Disgusting!
The buttons will erect some pillars, which you will find to be most exquisite when the queen decides to do that.
Oh. Do be careful! Yeah, this is not good.
Unfortunately, the pillars don't stick around for too long.
Yeah, it seems not, huh?
This bitch has a lot of health.
Oh god. I hate it! fuck it!
Don't forget you have your potion.
Yeah, I can't remember what the binding is for it. I think it's F, but I'm not sure.
Try E.
E does not work. F just worked. I was right!
Huh.
Oh god! Piss!
I guess you do have to press F to pay your respect.
Tits! Alright, this... There's definitely a timing factor that I need to get down.
I might be wondering, why is there these strange plates at the edges of this arena? Well, if you hurt the queen hard enough, you'll figure out why.
Oh, we're gonna figure it out. Luckily, we have infinite lives, so I don't really have to worry about- OW! Oh! OW! Oh! OW! Oh!
I think it might be just better to keep dying, for me at least, because I regenerate mana faster that way.
That's true. Yeah, eat that for me. Oh god, now
and there you have it! Once you hurt the queen hard enough, she will activate the spiked plates to make your life a little harder.
Well, at least it kind of clears the bugs out, but oh my god, fuck!
Why does this remind me so much of Earthworm Jim 2?
Earthworm Jim, a super suited fall! Earthworm Jim, a savior to us all! Earthworm Jim!
That cartoon was fucking terrible.
Terrible in the best way. I'll go back and watch it today. Go back and watch it after this playthrough. We got 5 up. Can you believe that shit?
Oh, 5 plus infinity equals infinity? Wowzers.
That's good math. Get behind that.
Speaking of Earthworm Jim, actually, I was pleasantly surprised to find out that the game called Enter the Gungeon actually has the same old red blaster from him.
Hmm.
And it does work exactly as you would expect it. It's kind of overpowered.
Well, I had a look at Gungeon and just, I have that weakness for bullet hell games, so I was like, I should buy this, but never did. Never did.
It's alright.
As most things go. Yeah, a lot of people suggested it just because it seems like something I would play on my channel, and I'm like, eh. I'm not in love with it.
I don't really see what makes it so good. I mean, it's alright, I kinda like it, but I only played with a trainer myself because I keep getting sick and tired of getting killed by bullshit every fucking time.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Plus some of the bosses
just- That's how every bullet hell game is.
Some of the bosses spam so many bullets in such dumb patterns, it gets so annoying to keep dodging them every time.
We can win! We can win! No, you can't. There is no winning.
Plus, I just wanted to see what happens if you collect all the parts for that bullet statue. I wasn't exactly planning to play for serious anyway.
Well, that's how most things go. You start out and you're like, I'm gonna play this for the channel, and it never happens. That's exactly what happened with Hammerwatch. I was like, this looks like an awesome game on sale, I'm gonna buy it. And then never played it. I guess finally I did, but it's a couple years behind.
Hey, better late than never.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter to me. I've never been like, oh, it's too old, it's not gonna get views. I just play what I like.
That's just bullshit. I know it is bullshit, because I've seen it happen myself. I've seen things that would make those people fucking shit their pants. There's no such thing as too old. I mean, seriously.
Yeah.
It's only too old like, if you want to make big money.
Exactly.
But
in
that case, why are you making Let's Plays if you want big money? Just make something
make
original
some top 10
instead.
Lists. Not even original, just make top 10 lists.
I think that market already got saturated as well.
Probably. I don't know. Any top 10 list I make does pretty well. It's like 200 to 300 views compared to like 30 to 50.
Nah.
Which for me is large. A large difference. Enough for me to go, yeah, we do this now.
I wouldn't do it. Mostly because I couldn't make a fucking list. I'm too lazy.
For Pokemon and stuff like that, I think it's pretty easy for me.
Oh,
just
because
I have a passion.
Speaking of Pokemans, speaking of the pocket monsters, I'm about
to
step...
Are you gonna get Sun and Moon?
I'm about to step on some toes, and it's gonna be pretty painful. I never played any of those.
Better be careful. Oh, really?
Never played a single Pokemonster game.
What?
Not a
single one. Aren't you younger than me?
Well, what do you mean by
younger?
How old are you?
I'm 28.
That's only 7 years.
Yeah, but it seems to me like you should have had some sort of draw to it.
No.
No? Okay, I guess
mean,
that solves
that. I played
that.
With a Tamagotchi, so that was the rage.
Oh, I love Tamagotchi.
Fucking love those things too.
I was gonna buy one.
Especially when you have to leave it overnight and you know you can't turn it off. Then you wake up and the fucking dog has shit himself all over the place, he needs medicine. He's fucking hungry
poor
and thirsty.
Little Tamagotchi.
And whenever you come back from school, your dog is dead. What the fuck was I supposed to do? I couldn't take it to school. Everyone would have stolen the damn thing from me. Oh, for fuck's sake.
You have to. You gotta take it to school.
Wait,
everybody will think you're so
first?
Cool.
No, fuck.
No, it's the far left one.
I forget these patterns.
Far
sometimes.
Right, far left, and then I can't remember. I guess it's...
Oh, for fuck's sake,
oops.
This bullshit. Well, I know how it goes then.
Yeah. Yeah, sequence completed. Something happened.
Cool.
Something happened!
I don't give a shit.
Oh, let's go in there. Can we go in there?
No, we don't have any keys.
Hello, monsters!
But if... I think the only thing that's close to pocket monsters was a phone game, but I can't remember what it's called right now. I think Monster Pet or something like that. It was a pretty fun game, actually.
Digimon, Digital Monsters.
Nope.
Oh.
Well, we did show that on TV at least, so I know what it is. But,
yeah, I kinda got sucked in by that too. And then I ended up in 6th grade, selling the fucking Digimon thing for, like, an exorbitant sum. I think the kid gave me, like, 30 or 40 bucks for
Jesus
it, and I was
Christ.
Like, pfft. Well, cause I told him I don't want to sell it. He's like, I'll give you 10, 20. I was like, no. And then he said, okay, I'll give you 40. And I was like, well, fuck. I don't even like this thing that much. Yeah.
What a sucker.
I'll sell it for 40.
I think we need to go past the fire blowers.
And batteries were not included.
Oh, that's the worst.
Yeah, that was a mean thing.
But yeah, in terms of pocket monster games, the only one that I played was, I think it was called Monster Pet for old phones, Nokias and whatnot.
My pet monster!
It was pretty fun, but the most annoying part about that game is if you wanted them to level up or anything, or for that matter, heal up,
oh,
you had
shit.
To leave the game on, which naturally drained the fucking battery.
Yeah.
It didn't check
that's
the timers
good.
On the system or anything. There was another monster game though, which I found a bit later, which was fucking weird. It was called My Monster Pet, and the fucking game was just about, well, playing the fucking Tamagotchi on your phone with a monster that looked like a giant dough of bread with a face on it.
That sounds cool.
Well, it was pretty fun, because, I mean, the fucking thing kind of talked. He was pretty happy to see you. It was the most interactive thing a kid could ask for. For his phone, no less. Unfortunately, the graphics kind of made sure that I never mentioned it to anyone.
This is my dirty secret.
It looked like it was pretty close to getting to Hello Kitty levels of graphics. But I didn't give a shit. It was my guilty pleasure.
Yeah. It's like Neopets or something.
I liked it. And eventually, the pet would grow big enough so it would just go away and leave an egg for you to grow a new one. It was fucking cool. I actually found that game recently on one of the old phone game archives that still exists. So I'll be able to make
really
a video
love those...
about that.
Yeah, I love those sites. I was going to make a Dino Park Tycoon video. Just like old fucking Mac game. I used to play it on the Mac.
Oh, the Macintosh. Before it was too shit.
Now it's just overpriced.
No, it's just hipster magnet.
Yeah. Which means overpriced. I used to go to the Goodwill all the time and buy nice clothes for fucking cheap, and then all these hipsters were like, buy fucking thrift clothes. It's like, well, how about you leave them shits for people that actually need it? Like your friend Dayton does.
Well, now that I think about it, Jeremy does have a Mac. I think he's a hipster in question. I think this.
Well, he will get mad if you call him a hipster, so I think that's.
I
even
think
more
that
proof.
Might be the case. Yes, I think this requires a thorough investigation. Whenever I start
tell
giving
me the
a
truth.
Shit. This actually did open something. This passage.
Didn't seem like anything happened.
This little corridor we just went past through. It doesn't normally show up unless you push that button.
I got wrecked so fucking hard.
It's okay. Dying is only a gateway. Or something like that. I don't know.
I hate it. Please leave me alone.
I hate how some of those skeletons drop banners which make them buffed. They didn't do that this often before.
Berserk.
Fucking
chop, 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 chop. Yeah. This is what I do now. Oh my god, look at the demon shrine.
Shit.
Oh my god, there's another demon shrine.
Don't get touched by that. It'll make you slow. It shoots freeze balls.
Mr. Freeze.
Okay.
Freeze well.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
I think if you destroy some of the statues, we'll get free upgrades, which is cool. Where the fuck is all my mana?
It goes quick. We should have turned on that mana regen shit.
Yeah, when I play by myself, I turn it on. So I can just walk around with my magical beam penis all over the place.
It keeps killing me! Why you keep killing me? I'm just a little thief trying to make some gold in the world. Is that so wrong?
Yes. I killed it.
That's true. There's like a set amount of people, and they're like, you can't be rich. You're not allowed to be rich, because then I won't be rich.
If you wanna be rich, you gotta be a bitch.
Right. You gotta suck some corporate cock.
An ancient Slav proverb.
It's accurate.
Yeah, it's very accurate.
If you wanna be rich, you gotta suck the corporate dick.
You gotta be a bitch. I haven't heard being said in such a long time. I feel so nostalgic. nostalgic.
Nostalgic for my youth.
I think the last time I heard that was from my sister.
Ah, goddamn.
Several years ago.
Dude, these guys are so foul.
Well, there are skeletons.
It's shooting at me! What the fuck are you doing over here? You can't be over here!
When I saw this one stranded here, I originally thought that you need planks to get these. That's not the case.
And you found out the hard way.
Yeah, the hard way of nothing happening.
I don't want to go over there.
That's okay, I can shoot through. There? Apparently I shoot above the grating. I don't mind that. It's always nice.
It's taller than I thought.
It's always nice when bullshit works for me.
Here they come. Bleh. Fuck. I'm dead.
A skeleton apple. That tastes delicious.
I don't like it.
Fuck. Since when do skeletons have mohawks?
Depends on the skeleton.
Well,
is he punk as fuck?
No, but he drops fucking banners.
Yeah, that's pretty punk. He's got a bum flap.
I almost never have any mana. This really needs to change.
Yeah, I almost never have any health.
Oh, but that's just because you need to get good.
I'm pretty good. I was like, not dying for a second. And then I did. And it was over.
For a second?
Right.
Should've been two. Oh, fuck.
You know... Oh, there he goes. There he goes. He's so leet. He falls over at his own leetness.
Well, I only died 8 times less than you did.
We'll bring it back around. Don't you worry.
No, I'm not gonna let that happen.
Ugh. This game is so difficult.
Well, it would be easier if you could use our mystical magical capabilities all the fucking time, but no, no region.
Yeah, I'd really like that. Get the fuck out of here!
It's okay. It means more parts
next
to upload
time.
And get more views.
Oh my god, did you die?
Yes, because I got point blank splooged by the statue.
I don't want to die!
Well then run. Run like the little bitch.
Just kind of keep dipping. Skipping and dipping.
Watch out for the boogers.
I killed all the boogers. I put them in my mouth and digested them, so I will have more immunity. Is that what it is?
Fuck.
Dude, that stuff is so foul.
I have a feeling that statue drains my mana. And I do not like that.
Okay. Good.
Well, that's fucking bullshit. I hit the switch and the coin just teleports away.
It doesn't like you.
Bullshit, it doesn't like me. It's gonna like me when I put it in my pocket.
I don't think it does. I don't think it wants to be that near to your crotch.
It's okay. It won't go to the crotch.
We'll call you Coin Crotch. Which is what actually my stripper name was.
My coins never go to my crotch. They go to my sock.
This is a terrible place to put it.
No, it ain't. Who's gonna look at
it's like a rock in your shoe.
Who's gonna look at the dirty old socks?
It's like a rock in your shoe all the time.
No, but this is where people are sorely mistaken. You see, if you stuff your socks full of coins, you can turn it into a very versatile weapon.
And if you stuff your pants full of socks,
you will look
very
creepy.
You got a giant dick.
So that doesn't quite work out as you would expect it. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ is here!
Introducing the Jesus Christ action figure with walk-on-water action!
I'm Jesus, King of the Jews!
You're not the King of the Jews!
Watch out, Jesus, it's a trap!
Crucify him!
Ugh! Jesus Christ!
Take that!
One, two...
Goodbye, goodbye, see you, my friends.